Good morning students, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and doing good. Now as you know, in the previous video we had done a topic called story writing. Do you remember students? And it was a very interesting topic, right? I had showed you the steps of how to write a story. So you all must have now learnt how to write a story. Yes or no? You all must have come to know that how you should write a story out of an outline. I have explained every detail in my previous video. So still if you are not clear about it, you can still watch my video of story writing. Okay students? And I had also given you some examples of outlines of stories so that you can write stories on your own. Yes or no? If you read books, your writing power, your writing skill will also improve. So you must always read story books. You must always read different stories. Then it would be easier for you to frame the sentences. Okay. Now, we will move forward with our next video. And in today's video, we will be discussing about picture composition. This is also a writing part. Okay, this is also writing part. And this is very interesting because you have to see the picture, and according to your imagination, according to your thinking, you have to write a few lines about the picture. If you want, you can make a story also out of the picture given to you. Okay students, if you are very skillful writer, if you have a lot of imagination, you can also make a story out of the picture given to you. Or else you can write a paragraph, you can write a few sentences about the picture. So today we will learn about picture composition, means how to write sentences on a picture. Okay, so that also has some steps. Means it is not very complicated. The steps, I am giving you the steps only so that you get an idea. Okay, so that you can learn some new things. I can directly teach you. Let's say this is picture composition, you must write the sentences like that. No, if I give you the steps of writing, then you may get some ideas. Okay, you may improve your skill, you may improve your writing skill. That is why I am showing you the steps. In story writing also I showed you the steps, and in picture composition also I will be showing you the steps of how you must write a paragraph or a few sentences on the picture given to you. Okay students, so let's see the slides on how to write sentences on a picture. Okay students, so today we will be discussing about picture composition. Okay, let's see the slides. Now see, here you can see many pictures are given to you. Can you see? There are many different pictures given to you. So you can see that they are all beautiful pictures, they are all colorful pictures, right? So now you can see the pictures and you can think about them. What is given in the picture? What is happening in the picture? Yes or no? You can see so many things and you can write many things. So what is picture composition? You know, picture composition means when you write about a picture, that is called picture composition. Just we will see the next slide. See, here the question is asked, what is a picture composition exactly? So a picture composition involves writing sentences based on a given picture. Okay, a picture composition requires a writer to carefully observe the given picture and describe it. It should have meaningful sentences. Okay students, so first of all, you know, you have to see the picture very carefully. You have to see very carefully, you have to observe, you have to see all the things what are given in the picture, and then you have to write about it, and it should have complete meaningful sentences. Now see, now we are going to see the rules for writing a picture composition. First of all, you have to look means you have to look at the picture very carefully and observe which scene is to be described. For example, suppose there is a picture of a garden, then you will write
this is a picture of a garden. Suppose it is a picture of a party, then you will write, this is a picture of a birthday party. Suppose there is a picture of a classroom, then you will write, this is a picture of a classroom. So your beginning sentence should be about the picture, about what the picture is, okay? About what the picture is, about what the scene is, okay? So that should be your first sentence. Now, what will be the next one? Objects. Now you have to see what all objects are given in the picture. Identify the objects that are there in the picture. There must be several objects in the picture. Sun, clouds. So you have to see what all the objects which are there in the picture. Suppose if it is a scenery, then you will see there will be sun, clouds, flowers, trees. Then suppose if it is a picture of a birthday party, then there will be children, there will be balloons, there will be the cake, there will be snacks, okay? Then there will be games. So first you have to identify the objects. Objects means what all is there in the picture, okay? You have to see carefully what all is there in the picture. Then the next, see here, some examples are given. See, you can see that there is a picture of a sun, then there is a picture of a children playing in the garden, and there is a picture of a rainbow, there is a picture of an aeroplane. Can you see? So I can easily make sentences out of this picture. See, I can say, the sun is shining brightly in the sky. Yes or no? Then I can say, the aeroplane flies high in the sky. Then a beautiful rainbow is there in the sky. Or you can say, the beautiful rainbow appeared in the sky. Then for the children, you can say that all the children are playing happily in the park. Okay, so you can write as many sentences as you want. Okay, as many sentences as you want. Now see, it is given, the sun is shining brightly. About the sun, the birds are flying in the sky. You can say about the clouds also, the clouds are floating in the sky. Then about the aeroplane, you can say an aeroplane is flying in the sky. Then about the rainbow, you can say a rainbow is looking beautiful in the sky. Yes or no? So what picture I showed you, about that only the sentences are given. So you can frame in any way you want, but they should be meaningful sentences. So first of all, you must identify all the objects. After you identify all the objects, it will be easy for you to write sentences. Yes or no? See, now here the next picture is also given. A squirrel is given. A dog is given. Then there are some birds sitting on the tree. There is a nest also. The birds are sitting around the nest. Then there are eggs in the nest. Okay, then the children are playing in the garden. Can you see? So first you must see what all. Then here you can see there are clouds, there are birds, there is a tree. So what all objects are there, you must first carefully see the objects. Okay? See, now see. About the picture, it is given, a huge tree is looking attractive in the park. So see, now I told you, you must see the objects. See, I will just show you again. So a huge tree is looking attractive in the park. Can you see a tree? A huge tree. This is a huge tree and it is looking attractive in the park. Then a bird is sitting in the nest. I told you about the bird. Yes or no? See, a bird is sitting in the nest. Or you can say a bird is sitting on the nest also. Eggs are lying in the nest. You can see that the eggs are there in the nest. So eggs are lying in the nest. A squirrel is sitting on the tree. You can see the squirrel. It is sitting on the tree. A boy is hiding behind a tree. Did you see? So here it is not shown clearly, but it might be behind this tree. Okay, here it is not shown clearly, but a boy must be hiding behind this tree. Okay, then the next one. A girl is sitting under the tree. You can see that a girl is sitting under the tree over here. She is sitting on a bench. And the last sentence is, she is reading a book. Now you can see, what is she doing? She is reading a book. Okay, students. So in this way, you have to see all the objects that are given in the picture and you have to frame such sentences about the picture. Okay, now we will see the next one. Now see, this again, a picture is given. Can you see? Of children playing in the park. This is a picture about children playing in the park. Now, first of all, what you have to do is that you have to see about what is the scene. Okay, this is a scene of a park. Then you have to observe all the objects that are given. You have to see what all is there in the picture. Around also you must see in the sky also you must see what is there. Trees are there, a dog is there, children are there, then slide is there. So you have to observe everything. Then you must frame sentences. Now see what sentence is given. A girl is taking a slide. Can you see a girl? So she is taking a slide. Taking a slide means she is sliding. Okay. A boy is enjoying a ride on a swing. The boy is also enjoying on a swing. Another boy is holding a ball in his hand. Can you see he is playing with a ball? Yes. So another boy is holding a ball in his hand. Then he is running with a dog and he is running with a dog. A cat is sitting near the slide. Now can you see the cat over here? It is sitting near the slide. One more boy is enjoying on a swing and the shape of the swing is like a duck. And one more boy is enjoying a swing and the shape of the swing is like a duck. So these many sentences you can easily write. This is a very small picture, but you can easily write these many sentences. See, if you want to write more sentences, you can write that there are big trees, there are huge trees in the park. Okay, then there are beautiful flowers also in the park. Okay, there are beautiful flowers. The flowers are looking beautiful in the park. Then you can see the sun is shining brightly in the sky. Then there are many clouds in the sky. So you can give all these sentences also. So you can make many many sentences out of this picture. Okay students, now we will see the next slide. See, now the next point which you have to be careful is about the tense. Whenever we are writing a picture composition, we use helping verb is, am, are and ing words. That means you have to write in present continuous tense. Okay, you have to write in present continuous. You must never write a picture composition in past tense or future tense. You know there are three tenses, right or no? Past, present and future. But this you have to write in present continuous tense. Present continuous tense means you have to use is, am, are. And where the verb is there, you have to put ing. See, for example, a boy is playing in the park. So the verb is playing. So you have added ing. You cannot write a boy played in the park or a boy will play in the park. No, you have to use only is, am and are. You have to use only is, am and are. A boy is playing in the park. The girls are sitting on the bench. Okay, students. So this you have to be careful. That you have to use only is, am and are. And ing. Behind the verb you have to put ing. Understood? So this thing also you have to be careful. Now we will see the next slide. Now the fifth point is about the paragraph. You must always write the picture composition in a paragraph. That is, start the next line where one ends. Now you know, all know what is paragraph, right or no? So you must always write the picture composition in paragraph. Do not put numbers. You must never put numbers in a picture composition like 1, 2, 3. Okay. You must never put numbers. You must write sentences or you must write a paragraph. For example, this is a picture of a garden. The sun is shining brightly. The boys are playing with a ball. Okay. So you can see that it is given in a paragraph. There are no numbers given. See, I told you. You must write in present tense, present continuous tense. That is RMC. How they have given? The sun is shining brightly. So they have used the word is and ing. Shining, ing, right or no? The boys are playing with a ball. See, again it is given ing and are. Now you know when to use is and are, right? You must have already learned in your previous classes. When it is singular, you use is. And when it is plural, you have to use are. Yes or no? And when it is I, you have to use am. So you can see, no, the boys are playing with the ball. So ing. Okay, so you must always use is, are, am and ing. On always write your picture composition in a paragraph. Do not put numbers. Okay, now we will see the next slide. Now, formation of sentence. How you must make a sentence? Whenever we are framing a sentence, the following thing should be kept in mind. Do not begin the sentence with there. You must never use there. Okay, like there is a ball, or there is the sun, or there are birds. Don't begin your sentence with there. Okay, so in a picture composition, never start a sentence with there. And the second point is, use a word woman for female and man for male. So whenever there are ladies in the picture, you must never you must always say woman. And for if there are males in the picture, you have to say man. You have to not use mother, father, grandfather, grandmother, lady. Okay, you must never use this word like mother, father, sister, brother, or lady, or gentleman. Never use these words. You must use woman and you must use man. You have to use the word woman and man. If it is singular, if it is many, you have to use women and men. Okay, but you must never use words like mother, father, grandfather, grandmother, lady, and gentleman. So this also you have to be careful. Okay, students. Now this is the last point, that is conclusion. Conclusion means the end. Wind up the picture composition with some interesting observation. See, your last sentence should be very interesting. Okay, it should be the most impressive one. The last line could be the most impressive part of your composition. So you must make the last line, you must write the last line very interesting. You must try to make it very interesting about the picture. Okay, and then final draft should be checked thoroughly. And then you must, after you complete writing the whole picture composition, you must check it thoroughly, whether you have put the correct punctuation marks, whether you have written it grammatically correct, whether all the spellings are correct. So this all things you must be very careful. Okay, students. Now see here, the last sentence is very interesting. I had told you, your last sentence must be interesting. See, for example, beautiful flowers are blooming in the park. The park is neat and tidy. Everyone is looking happy, or everyone is enjoying in the park. So see, this sentence became interesting, that everyone is looking happy, or you can write everyone is enjoying in the park. Okay, students, so you understood, no, that the last line should be interesting or impressive. Okay, now let's do one picture composition together. We will just do one picture composition together so that you get a more clear idea. Now describe the given picture in 10 sentences. Now this picture is given and you have to write 10 sentences about it. So let's see which are the 10 sentences. This is a picture of a park. So I told you, first you must write about what the scene is. So this is a picture of a park. Okay. The sun is shining brightly. A bird is flying in the sky. An old woman and a girl are sitting on a bench. So you can see, the sun is shining brightly in the sky, the bird is also flying, and an old woman and a girl are sitting on the bench. So I told you, see, you must not write grandmother and daughter. You must never use this word. You must always use woman, or for girls, small children, you may use girl or boy, not brother, sister, friend. Okay, no grandmother, mother. So you have to write a woman and a girl are sitting on a bench. So this was a rule. Okay, now the next one is, they are reading a book. A boy is standing behind them and another boy is running with his dog. So you can see that the girl and the woman are reading a book. Then a boy is standing on a tree. Sorry, a boy is standing behind them and another boy is running with a dog. Okay. Then one more girl is taking a ride on a scooty. You can see that one girl is taking a ride on a scooty. This is called a scooty, or you can say a cycle also. Okay. Two children are playing on the trunk of a tree. Now you can see two children, they are playing on the trunk of a tree, or you can say the branch of a tree. Everyone is enjoying in the park. Now you saw the last sentence, it is very interesting. Everyone is enjoying in the park. So even you must write the last sentence in this way. Understood, students? So this was a good example of how you must write a picture composition. Okay, students, see, for your practice, you may write some sentences about this picture. Can you see this picture? Yes, it is a very beautiful, colorful picture. There are many, many things given. Can you see? So you can just take a screenshot or you can do whatever you want and you can just write it in your rough book. You must try to make sentences. You must try to make a paragraph on this picture. Okay, students, so I have just given you for your practice. Then I think there is one more picture. Yes, this is about a room. So you can write many sentences about this room also. Okay, so you make a few sentences, at least try to write at least 6 sentences on each picture. You can write 6 sentences on each picture. I have given 2 examples to you. Okay, students, so you can practice writing. This is very necessary. Okay, it will improve your writing skill. Now, for your activity, even in worksheet, it is given. In your application book also, it is given. See worksheet 2.8. Okay, in your application book, there is a worksheet 2.8. In that, 2 picture compositions are given. 2 pictures are given and you have to write sentences about them. So, please try to do this activity and try to write the sentences on your own. There are 2 pictures given, okay, and you have to write a picture composition. So even in your application book, an activity of picture composition is given. So please practice it.
Okay, students, so I have taught you how to write a picture composition. I have given you all the steps. Please see the video again and again and you will be very clear. And I hope you all have understood how to write a picture composition. And please practice the pictures what I gave you for your activity. And even practice the pictures that are given in your application book. Okay, students, I hope you have enjoyed my video. Thank you for watching my video and have a nice day.